Let's go over how to connect to MongoDB with Mongoose. First, make sure you have MongoDB installed and the daemon running. Now run npm install mongoose. This will install the module to your local directory. Once that's done, open your text editor and create a new file, connection.js. This will contain the database connection logic. In order to use mongoose, you must require it. Then call mongoose.connect and pass in the MongoDB connection URI. The string breaks down to the following: the connection format prefix, the optional username and password credentials, which aren't required in our case, the host, the optional port that defaults to 27017 if not specified, and the optional database name. Don't worry if the name doesn't exist, as MongoDB will create it once there's data. Feel free to check out the documentation for more options and information on the string. Save the file and go back to your terminal. Run the script by typing node connection and then hitting enter. You'll notice that it runs forever. Although no feedback is displayed on whether it's connected or not, you can switch to the MongoDB window to check if a single connection has been accepted. Let's go back to our script and log the connection status. We'll listen to events on mongoose.connection since mongoose.connect happens asynchronously. On event connected, we can log that the connection succeeded. Save the file and go back to your terminal. Terminate the running process by pressing Ctrl-C. Now hit the up arrow and press Enter to rerun it again. You'll see your message logged out. But what about disconnects and connection failures? Well, going back to the file, we can listen to the disconnected event, which is self-explanatory. You also have the error event, which happens when the connection throws an error. You can access the error object in the callback's first argument. Additionally, there's a process sigint event, which happens when a signal interrupts the process. Here, we want to gracefully close the connection. Log a helpful message afterwards and exit the node process. Finally, you can export the connection object so other files can use it. Go back to your terminal and rerun the script. When you terminate it this time, you'll see the additional messages logged out. Check out the documentation for more information on Mongo's connection options and events. And that's a basic introduction on how to connect to MongoDB with Mongoose.